Hello everyone, Alex here from WarrenOffKeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you two things, the first of which is fairly simple, and that is a delete channel command. The second is to have channels get automatically created whenever they're necessary, and then deleted whenever they're not necessary anymore. So an example of that is we have this tutoring channel here in the WarrenOffKeys Discord. I want it so whenever someone joins, then another empty one will be created automatically, but whenever someone leaves, and leaving that existing channel empty, it would then delete that. So to get started, we can create a new command here, and this is using my command-based system, which I have covered in a previous video. A link to that will be in the video description. If you don't care about the inner workings of this, you can simply just clone this from the GitHub repository. I'm going to make a new command within our commands folder. This will be called delete-channel.js, and I'm going to export a JSON object. The first property is going to be our commands, and this is going to be delete-channel or del channel, either one will work. Our max args will be 0, because we don't want the user to actually specify any arguments. They're going to be able to delete a channel based off of whatever text channel they're typing inside of. And then the permissions will be administrator, and this requires them to have an administrative role on the actual Discord. And then we have permission error, which will be this text that is sent to them whenever they don't have this. We can say, you must be an admin to use this command. Now finally, we're going to have our callback. This is going to be a function here with the message, the arguments, and the text. We don't actually care about the text and the arguments, but I'm including them here just so you know that they exist for other commands. And here, we can simply just run message.channel.delete. So if I save this and I run the bot with node index.js, it'll say registering command delete channel right here. Going into Discord, I could then create a new text channel. I'll just call this temp. I'm going to make this only visible to owners. And I'm going to go into here and I'm going to use exclamation point del channel. And it automatically deletes the channel and sends us over to this new content channel. So that is how you're going to delete a channel. Now I'm going to close that and I'm going to make a new file. This one will be called scalingchannels.js. And I'm going to start by copying the name of my tutoring channel here, so I can simply edit this. So constant channel name equals this. And then I'm going to export a function. So module.exports, and this is going to take in one argument, which is the client. We can now go into our main file and I can import this. So constant scaling channels equals require scaling channels. And then I'm going to call this passing in the client. I can save and close this. All of our logic will be inside of this file. The first thing I want to do is I want to listen for the voice state update event, which is going to occur whenever someone joins or leaves a voice channel. So client.on voice state update. This is then going to have a function here that'll have two arguments. The first one is the old state. The next one is the new state. Now inside of here, we want to gain access to the guild so we can destructure that from old state. So next we're going to create a constant called joined. And this is going to be a Boolean whether we've actually joined or left a specific voice channel. And so to actually gain access to this, we can use not new state dot channel ID. So the channel ID property, if we're joining a channel, is going to have an actual ID, whatever that might be. But if we're leaving a channel, we're going to get undefined or null or some type of falsity value like that. So if we have undefined and we say not undefined, we're then going to get true. And then if we say not true, we're then going to get false. So essentially putting two not symbols right next to each other is going to confer any falsy value, like an empty string, undefined, null, or anything like that, into false, which is still a falsy value, obviously, but I'd rather just use Booleans instead. After that, we're going to gain access to the channel ID. So constant channel ID, we're gonna say if joined, using a ternary operator here, we're going to say new state.channel ID. Otherwise, we're gonna say old state. Dot channel ID. Like I mentioned, if we're joining, then the new state will have a channel ID. Otherwise, this will be undefined. But if we're leaving, then the old state is going to have the channel ID. And so this is going to give us a channel ID whether we joined or left, either way. Then we're going to gain access to the channel. So we can say guild.channels.cache.git. We're going to pass in the channel ID. After that, we can say if channel.name is exactly equal to channel name, which is the constant we defined up here. Now at this stage, we actually want to see if we've joined. And if we have, we want to get all of the existing channels that is using this name. So I'm actually going to make a new function above our export here. So const get voice channels. And this is going to take a guild as an argument. And then we're going to say return guild.channels.cache.filter. And this is essentially going to loop through all of the guilds within the cache. And then we're going to be able to return certain ones in an array depending on what we return within this function here. So .filter takes a function, like I just mentioned, and we're going to have access to a channel here. And we are simply going to return if channel.type is exactly equal to voice and channel.name is exactly equal to channel name. So this is essentially going to return an array of all channels within our Discord, or within our guild rather, that is going to have this exact name. Now, with that said, I could say const channels equals get voice channels and pass in the guild. And then I can say let has empty equals false. This is essentially going to be a Boolean that is going to see if we have an empty tutorial channel, or an empty tutoring channel, I mean. And if we don't have an empty tutoring channel, then I want to automatically create an empty tutoring channel that has the same exact setup with the same exact name and member count limits and all of that as our existing channel here. So after this, we can actually loop through all the channels. So channels.forEach. We're then going to have access to each channel here. And we want to say if not has empty and channel.members.size is exactly equal to 0. This is going to be the actual number of people connected to that voice channel. Then I want to say has empty equals true. So now after this, has empty will be a Boolean depending on if there's any empty voice channels. And we can simply say if not has empty, then we want to actually create a new voice channel. So I'm going to start off by destructuring some information from the channel. That way, when we go to create the next channel, it's going to have all the same exact properties like I mentioned previously, like the name and the maximum member limits and all that. So we're going to have the type, the user limit, the bitrate, the parent ID, which is where it is on the category. For example, this one is under voice channels, and so we want it to be directly below this channel. We would then want the permission overwrites, which are going to be the actual permissions. For example, right here, just for testing, so people don't see me joining and leaving this channel a whole bunch, if we edit this and go to permissions, we see that you cannot connect to this channel unless you're the owner. And so whenever we go to duplicate this channel and create a new one programmatically, we're going to see that it has all the same permissions here. Last one is the raw position. And so now that we have access to all that information, we then want to say guild.channels.create. This is going to take in the first argument as the channel name, which is the constant we have at the top of our file. And then the second argument is going to be an object we called options. We can pass in our type, our bitrate, our user limit. It needs parent, which will be parent ID. And then it needs permission overrides, and then the position, which would be the raw position. Now at this stage, it'll actually create a channel whenever we are joining a new channel. So let's test this out. I can save this and I can run my bot with node index.js. I could then go in here. We see we have one tutoring channel if I join. Okay, so we actually have an exception here. I simply just forgot to capitalize the I right here in channel ID. So if we save this and then restart, I can go back and I can join. And we see it created another tutoring channel right here. And we see that this new channel has a max of 2 members. And if I go to edit the channel and look at the permissions, it has the same exact permissions. So it's essentially just a complete clone of the tutoring channel. So now when I go to actually leave, we see that it doesn't actually delete anything. We also get an exception here. Okay, so this exception is because the channel didn't exist. That's because this is supposed to be channel ID with a capital D. So whenever we're accessing the channel ID from the states here, we use capital I and capital D. I prefer to use capital I and then lowercase d. So that's just something to keep in mind. Obviously, that's just personal preference. But now that we've saved that, this should not be a problem anymore. There's a couple more things we want to do here. So after our if joined, we want an else if. Now here we want to say if the channel we just left is now empty and there's at least one other channel, then we want to go ahead and delete the channel that we just left. So else if channel.members.size is exactly equal to 0 and get voice channels passing in the guild.size is greater than 1. If this is the case, we then want to say channel.delete. I can save this and I can run the bot again. I'm going to manually delete this one channel that was created. But if I join the tutoring channel, we then see it creates another channel. But if I leave, it then deletes that channel. And so if I join another one, it doesn't actually keep creating them because it knows not to. But if I leave this one, it's going to delete it. And so this is how you're going to make your channels automatically scale up and scale down. And so this might be useful for this exact use case here, where we have different tutoring channels, or you might have different support or interview channels or whatever you might have where you want it. So whenever someone joins, there's always going to be an empty pending one. However, those channels do get deleted when they're not necessary anymore, and that means whenever the users leave. Thanks for watching this Discord.js tutorial. If you want to learn more about Discord.js, consider clicking on the playlist you see on your screen now. If you need help, feel free to leave a comment or ask in the Warnoff Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description.